the seed of forgiveness. Now many people have forgiveness by their emotion or by their feeling. Forgiveness is not by your feeling, it's a decision. Faith is not feeling. Say that. Faith is believing. And believing is action corresponding to the message. So when you said, Lord, in your name I have forgiven this person and I blessed this person, now you got to keep believing. The devil will keep on reminding you of the past and say, do you remember what she said and what she did to you? Then if you remember, how can you say that you are forgiven? Jesus said forgive. He did not say forget, forgive and forget. Hey, Jesus said when he repents and comes back, you forgive and forget. He said forgive. He did not say forget. So just because you remember does not mean that you have not forgiven. Because the devil will always say, see, you remember what she did. See, you remember. I don't care even if I remember. I forgive. I have forgiven. I have blessed that person. Praise the Lord. Come on, give the Lord a big hand of praise. Okay.
Okay.
And now somebody might say that and try that and try to put people into the snare. Now, you did not hear what Jesus was saying. That's why you kept your mouth shut. Jesus said, woe to him who leads others into the snare. Did Jesus say that? Come on. I think he forgot that. Other this man keeping quiet, impossible. Okay, go ahead.
Okay.
The seed faith.
The seed faith.
Talk about how your house came. Seed faith. Very nice.
Center came. Center.
Okay.
When I met him about 10 years back, all what he had was a Maruti van and a bike. Okay. I used to, after the first class, I think the second class, I got interested in knowing where he's going around preaching the word. So I used to sit with him and go wherever he's preaching. My main motive was to find out what he's doing and the testimonies to meet people and to believe, you know, because I am little of that type of mentality. So you don't know, like me, there are so many people coming here for with different mentality to check out. Okay, so don't worry, this is common. I know one brother was telling me, I had just come for the first time only to see. Next time I came and I was crying here listening to the word of God. I was not there, you were. Praise God. So there are some people who come to see, just like me, and some sit on the bike, or some even come home to see what is there. Where is Mother Mary? Where is the cross? Where is the altar? Where is the Bible? So many things are there like this. Yes or no? Okay, we are talking about a seed. Where you can take me?
Okay, go ahead.
And as he was, you heard about the giving is not only the word. I told him, giving is only the word, not the purse. I saw him emptying the purse when he was going in the orphanages, when he was going to meet the nuns who are handling the orphanages. He would just empty his purse after praying over them, after preaching the word of God. So he was talking about, he was sowing a seed, what he was believing. He had that faith. He did not have any money more than what he was sowing. He used to give, just empty the purse, telling me that this is what God says. What is, if you give, it shall be given unto you. Pressed down, shaken together, running over, man put into your bosom.
Can I speak something? Before you continue. Do you know how this person began to believe? This brother began to come for the next Bible class and the next Bible class. And there was this lady who came and shared a testimony. I'm on the fourth floor. Do you remember?
Yeah, yeah.
And the roof is broken. And every year the rain is coming. Housing board, Bombay, housing board, mine.
Next to the railway line.
You know the condition of those buildings?
The old buildings.
So we put buckets
down
to collect water. Some water comes by tap, some comes by ceiling. Okay? So by morning, the bucket is full. Okay? So when she heard the teaching on faith speaking to the mountain, she went back home and spoke to the ceiling to become waterproof. Okay? And the following 2 days, there were heavy rains. And she came for the Bible class and she said, you know, the ceiling has become dry and there's not a drop of water. And this brother...
And you are preaching the same thing. Yeah.
So this brother of mine puts his neck out and looks at her and says, where are you staying? Okay. Now, everybody in the class is believing. One person, Saint Thomas, says, I want to go and see it myself. So every time he's on the bike, he's saying, let's go there. And I'm saying, there is a time for everything. There are other important things where people are dying, let's go there. And somehow we reached at Mime because we were going somewhere. And he said, Mime? I said, yes, let's go. And that day also it was raining. So we took him there. And like a news channel, his eyes are small, but that time it's open. Show how big it is. You can see? He is opening his eyes, looking everywhere. You can see the iron beams inside because the ceiling is all open. Okay? And this lady is saying, can you see those marks all dried up? That's where it was to come. It's absolutely dry.
It is raining, but it's not leaking anymore now.
It's not leaking anymore now. Now, when he saw it with his eyes, my brother broke down and began to cry. And he said, Lord, why am I like Saint Thomas? Why I can't believe? Like the simple people believed and made that prayer of faith. They planted the seed of faith. That was the end of Alred. Alred died in that person's house completely. After that, whenever something is said, he says, I believe. And from there, his new life began of believing.
Hallelujah.
You remember that?
Yes, of course. And you thought, for the first Bible class in that house, you thought this. When I came, they were sharing on what happened the last time. How the word of God was effective. How they went home. How they cursed. Yeah. How they said, get out. Yeah. For the leakage. Yeah, and it became dry. So when they were sharing it, I was wondering how this is possible. I have never heard such stories like this.
Story? Testimony.
Now it is a testimony. For those, for our first timers, it's a stories. Okay. So then he gave me another scripture, give and it shall be given unto you. That's why I give. I am not giving because I feel like giving. I don't feel like giving. I only feel like speaking, and after speaking, cover taking.
Not now. Old Alred.
So when he showed me that, when I was trying to tell him what I feel, he said it is not on feelings, it is on what?
Believing.
Just now the note is, faith is not a feeling but believing. So he told me it is written here, and this is the seed. This is the seed I am planting. I cannot see the harvest, but I am planting a seed because I know this harvest will come. So I began to believe that giving is important. Not only this speaking, the word of God, not only preaching, but also giving is important. By a preacher, by a priest, by a nun, everyone. Praise the Lord.
Can I share something?
Yeah.
When you go for mass.
Yes.
The offertory begins.
Yes.
The person who comes to take the offertory, has he ever gone to the altar boys?
No.
Because they are not supposed to give. Has he ever gone to the nuns? Because they are not supposed to give. I keep watching. Do they go to the choir? But they are not supposed to give. Only we people are supposed to give.
Yes or no? What we see?
And what about as the offertory person ever gone to the priest?
No.
My friend, every one of us are supposed to be givers.
Because it just says give to everyone. It says give. Whoever reads the word of God,
I'll tell you how I realized that. Because when I was sitting at mass and I opened my purse, the Lord said, son, just look around. And I was looking around and the person came, never went to the altar boys. Have you ever seen? Never went to the choir. And the nuns were sitting in one row. That fellow missed the nuns and went to the next bench. I saw it.
No, we were doing it also. I, as an altar boy, I have also done that. I have never gone to the priest. Or if I was not an altar boy, I have seen that. That altar boys, they will not remove it because
okay.
It's not a habit. So, but what is the word of God that is? It's a command, give. Whoever it is. Praise God. So, he gave me that seed. So, I began to change my feeling, change my thinking. Then he began to speak that he had met a brother who was having TB, who was having HIV. So, this brother got healed.
He was a drug addict.
Mm. Yeah. And he got healed and he went back in the world to work. Yeah. So, brother, he told him, he put a seed saying that many people like me are dying. You must work for them or you must
do
something for them. And so when I met him, he began to tell me that we will do something for the alcoholics, drug addicts, people who are broken. He's got a bike, he's got a Maruti van, and he's saying we'll have a rehab center, free rehab center. We'll have a retreat house to preach the word of God day and night.
Free.
Free. Everything free. We will give free food, free stay. And I have got no chance, no option to say anything because now I have to believe. Praise God. So I say, yes, brother, we'll do it.
Honestly speaking, I love this brother very much. You know why? One question he'll say, when I speak something from the word of God, he'll say, are you sure what you're saying? I said, I'm sure it's written. If it is written and you're sure, whatever it is, I'm ready to agree with it. See, the Bible says wherever you get two people agree on anything, the Heavenly Father will do it. When I shared in a team that we do everything free, we don't sell the CDs, we don't collect money, many left me and went. And this brother said, brother, I am agreeing with you, let's do it. There were many who would not agree. They said, how will you run? How are the expenses going to be met? I said, I don't know. But I know one thing, that the seed of faith is supposed to bring in the harvest.
Hallelujah. So I began to believe. You see some old books with numbers, trail of numbers in Goa. We had so many of us. Yeah. Now we are just, if you have that. Yeah. Now we have only just few numbers on the Goa. In Goa, right? Goa and Bombay. Otherwise, Goa and Bombay was a big list because we had many. Praise God. But as he began to say these things which could not be believed, only I used to agree with him. So many left. Hallelujah.
I don't mind people leaving. But praise God, when they go and do the same job and souls are one, praise God, whether they are in this branch or that branch, they are working in the kingdom of God.
We shall rejoice.
See, I believe we all work for the same master. Yeah? And the company is one. Right? You win 100 souls or that person will 1,000 souls. As long as souls are saved, we shall rejoice. Might be a Protestant preach and a soul got saved. A Pentecostal preach and a soul got saved. A Catholic preach and a soul got saved. Thank God the soul got saved.
Hallelujah.
Because the Jesus of Protestant, Pentecostal, New Life or Catholic, the Jesus is the same. His eyes don't change. The color doesn't change. The hair doesn't change. Now, it's not that Catholic Jesus has got blue eyes and Protestant Jesus has got black eyes. He's the same Jesus. We are of the same body of Christ. Brothers and sisters in Christ. But you know, many a times I begin to wonder, when a Pentecostal comes to your house, a pastor comes to meet, everybody will talk. You know, the pastor came to their house. But when a Hindu person comes to your house, no problem. If we can't love our brother and sister who believes in Christ, how can we believe a person who doesn't, how can we love a person who does not believe in Christ? The mark of a Christian is, I don't see who you are, I see Christ in you. That's all.
Hallelujah.
That's all. It settles.
Hallelujah.
But on the pulpit we'll say we should love everybody. If you really want to love everybody, show evidence of love.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, go ahead.
So what he said, we'll have a free rehab center for the boys, we'll have a free retreat house, all those things were impossible to believe or agree. Praise God. But as I began to say yes, yes, it did not happen in first year, second year. Means 1 year has 12 months, 1 month has got 30 days. What he says is not happening immediately, but slowly, slowly, as he began to preach, as we began to agree, slowly, slowly, we began to see God was unfolding.
I think it happened in 9 years. 9 years or 10 years before, when I was talking with no money in my pocket, it looked so foolish. I looked like a joker. But praise God, 10 years later on, when the center came up, praise God, even I did not think it would be so big. And the Lord said, son, you just received the first installment. I want you to get pregnant and plant some more seed faith. Imagine everyone, listen, you know the big problem with us? Our seed faith is all about us. My life, my husband, my wife, my children. But if you are a true Christian, you will be planting the seed of faith to bring great profits in the kingdom of God.
Hallelujah.
Because when you think about the kingdom, when you get involved in God's dream, God gets involved in your dream. Hey, when you get involved in God's dream, God is ready to get involved in your dream. But you are all the time saying, God, don't talk to me about your dream. Get into my dream. Short circuit.
First seek his kingdom. Seek the kingdom of God. Rest. Your dreams will come. Praise God. So it's all about seeds that we are.
And I'll tell you, my friend, we did not go to ask money. Who is going to give us the money? Who is going to do this? Who is going to do the construction? Who is going to do that? The final result was declared and programmed in that seed faith. God knew to bring the person from the north, south, east, west. I don't know. Even if he's on the North Pole, God will bring him and get the job done.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And regarding the offense, as we were talking, actually we had a good chance to get offended. It was just before the retreat house could come up. We had just started the rehab home, and just before the retreat house could be planned,
massive offense. There was such a massive situation that had happened that I was preaching in Bangalore, and my brother called me in the evening and he said, listen, I just want to quit. I don't want to do anything. That's a special anointing. I just want to quit. And listen, I don't want to continue any longer.
It's about 6 years back.
Six years. And I said, listen, can you wait for 24 hours? And I was preaching in Bangalore. I called up my wife and I said, I'm leaving for Goa. From the pulpit, straight into the bus, the next morning I'm there. And I said, let's call for a meeting. And everybody came. And the issue was that this brother had a problem in his disc. He had got healed, and I never gave him to carry anything heavy, because
still now he doesn't give me anything.
So I know that that's a problem. God has healed him, but you know, he has to take care. So that day, just a few months back, he carried something heavy and bang, he began to get that pain. He was in the hospital for a month and all that. Now, somebody told him he has to get into a massage hospital where they put oil, hot oil and massage. And he was there for 20 days. And the retreat was going on. In that hospital, on the phone, he organized everything. The whole retreat got over and nobody knew where Alred was. Now, the big problem was everybody were angry that he did not say that he was sick. And he said, why should I say that I'm sick when by the wounds of Jesus I'm healed? Now they said, but why didn't you tell me? He said, listen, even though I was in the hospital, I have fulfilled everything, my responsibility, everything, organizing the food, the this and that and that and everything. Then I began to ask my brothers, in the month we have got 5 days of retreat. The 5 days of the retreat, you are there. What about the next 25 days? He is there 30 days. And they were offended.
And they left.
Praise God. And they said, we don't want to do anything. And Alred began to cry. And Alred said, brother, it's better that I quit instead of all of them quitting. I said, my friend, it's better for me to have one person of love and faith together than having 100 people along with me who are in strife. If 100 army are together in strife, the Holy Spirit will never show up in that place. Comes where there is unity and love. That's why on the day of Pentecost, it's clearly given 120 of them were assembled and they were in one accord.
One mind. Hallelujah.
They were in one accord.
Hallelujah.
I said, brother, don't you quit. It's time for a bigger blessing. Let's start all over again. And praise be to God. God opened this place in Kalangut just before the blessing came this big and everyone left. Everyone left. Imagine everyone leaving in one day because he did not report he was sick. Offense, and because one person got offended, it's very important when one person gets that seed of offense, he will go and tell.
Yeah, planting of
the. You are a. By the time it is contagious. When somebody comes and speaks to you something negative about somebody, that's a snare of the devil. Don't get into that snare. It will kill you. So 9 years back, everything was finished. This brother wanted to quit.
Six years.
And I said, listen, brother, if God has brought us this far, he knows where to take us. Let's start all over again. We got the word. We got the love. Let's walk again. And praise be to God. God began to do marvelous things. And I always tell brother, the big problem is the day you give somebody a badge.
We give people responsibility.
You give a person responsibility and you give a volunteer's badge. You know that yellow,
member,
green, blue color?
Team member, volunteer.
Volunteer. That badge when a person gets, my God, that person is totally different.
Power circuit.
We have seen people getting into a mess when they get a badge. That's why I keep telling brother, don't give anybody a badge. I'm losing nice people.
Another issue was also that I was enforcing to learn the word of God from the, I think about 8 or 9, from the time I came to know that the word of God is important, which I had already wasted time without knowing the word of God. Okay, I was going with him, but I was not studying the word of God. I was not speaking the word of God, not saying. Jesus says, say to this mountain. Praise God. I was not saying, I was reading. Praise God. We are not only reading the menu, we are saying the order, what we want, right?
Just before we go, just read the scripture and we close down. For it was not an enemy that reproached me, then I could have borne it. Psalms 55, 12 to 14. Neither was it he that hated me that did magnify himself against me. Then I would have hid myself from him. But it was he, a man, equal, my guide and my acquittance. We took sweet counsel together and walked. My friend, you will say, once I've come to this place and I'm listening to the word of God, everything is going to be fine. But the psalmist says, more hurts and more things on the negative side will come those who worship in the house of God. Your fellow believer will hurt you. The person with whom you are expecting the most, the greater the offense will come. Because the higher the expectation, the greater the fall. And I used to always say to my brother, whenever we do anything, don't expect anything. Always expect from God. Because when your expectations are not met, you are offended. Let's close eyes. Remember, my friend, before a great blessing came, we had to pass the test. The test of offense. Every moment in our life, opportunities of offense will come. From your loved one, a person equal to you, a person who has been your guide, a person with you, who stayed with you, acquainted with you, counseled together, walked unto the house of God together, hurt will come. If you are a person who is all the time expecting from others, the higher the expectation, the greater the fall. The closer the relationship, the more severe the offenses. The greatest hatred is among people who are once close. Remember, my friend, only those whom you care can hurt you. Those who are in opposition with you are not aware that they are held prisoners to do the devil's will. When you become bitter, you are deceived. You become a prisoner. The Lord is again and again saying to you, the more you focus on yourself, the more you will live a disappointed life, and your expectations are not going to be met. People can only disappoint you to the degree they fall short of your expectation. You are setting yourself for an offense. If you demand a certain kind of behavior from those in relationship with you, when that kind of behavior is not met, you are offended. This evening, as you are leaving from this place, use that book that God has given you. Every page over there is filled up with faith seed, programmed for different areas of your life. And my friend, as you plant this seed faith, refuse to walk in offense. Walk in that unconditional love. And just as Jesus sent the 72 and they returned back with great joy, saying, Jesus, in your name, the demons were subject to us. In the same way, the Lord is sending you to go from this place so that you come back with joy, saying, Jesus, truly, I planted the seed of faith. I forgived my brother seven times and more than seven times in a day.